Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we're going to bring in our wedding party. First up, we have Chuck and Kathy Bolds. Dave and Cheryl Kelly. Caitlin Bolds and Kelly Kaminsky. Courtney Kelly and John Kelly. Ali Bapa and Lou Ebert. Kelly Moran and Nate Ray. Elena Kelly and Ricky Rodriguez. Our maid of honor and best man, Allison Kelly and Pete Witt. At this time, I need y'all to get up off your feet and start making some noise for our bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Greg and Lauren Kaminsky. At this time, everybody paid your attention to the cutting of the cake. All right. Let's give them a big round of applause.
Hi. So for those of you who may not know us, I'm Elena, and this is Allison, and we're Lauren sisters. We are so excited to be able to share this beautiful celebration of the start of a new chapter in Greg and Lauren's lives. Lauren has not only been more than the best big sister we could have ever asked for, but a best friend as well as a role model.
We always wanted to be just like Lauren, intelligent, beautiful, generous, hardworking, compassionate, loving, and supportive. We wanted to do everything Lauren did. We followed her around so much when we were little, she used to lock us out of her bedroom just to escape her mini-me's. when she, especially when Kelly Moran, one of her best friends, would come over and they would play Barbies, her favorite toy.
Although Lauren did like spending time alone with her friends, she would always play with us as soon as they went home. One of my favorite memories from spending time with Lauren when we were younger was when she would let us join in playing Barbies. Lauren had the coolest dollhouse, the best outfits, and of course, the most popular dolls. One time when we were playing Barbies in her room, she did not have enough Ken dolls for everybody to play with. All Lauren had left was a headless Ken doll, which she offered me. I was distraught and I did not want to take it, but Lauren would not let me go without a Ken. She decided that she would fix my Ken by drawing a smiley face on a piece of paper and taping it to Ken's headless neck. Although it wasn't the most attractive doll and his head was a tad bit floppy, Lauren really tried to make sure I was happy, and it did the job. In all seriousness, Lauren truly has found the Ken to her Barbie, and he has a very good head on his shoulders.
Can you hold? Greg and Lauren's love story began 8.5 years ago when they started dating while Lauren was in high school and Greg was in college. As long-distance relationships can be tough, Greg and Lauren always found a way to make it work. They truly are one of the happiest couples we have ever met and genuinely love and adore each other. Like Lauren, Greg is also very compassionate, supportive, motivated, hardworking, and kind. Sorry, I just didn't want to leave anything out. I mean, I could describe you, but I was like, I really want to make sure I say these things. I believe this is why they are the perfect match.
Greg proposed to Lauren on Christmas Eve of 2013, which was one of the best Christmas gifts Lauren and our family could have ever received. Christmas time has always been one of the happiest times for us, as well as our sister, from baking cookies galore while watching Elf to spending time with family and friends. Greg truly picked the perfect timing to ask Lauren to marry him. Greg made a scrapbook with a collection of pictures of Lauren and himself growing up to when they met each other, which eventually led to the last page of the book, which had a ring tied onto it. We were so excited. We were so excited to officially have Greg as a part of our lives.
Greg and Lauren work as a team, and they are always willing to help in any way possible. Greg has taken on a big brother role in our lives as well, from doing an oil change to taking us to the movies or just eating dinner together. Greg, we really love you, and we are so happy that we have someone as wonderful as you as our new brother.
We got more! Okay.
Lauren and Greg, we are so happy for the both of you, and we are so blessed to have you both in our lives. We are humbled to be able to share this day with you two, and we look forward to the amazing future ahead of you two.
With love and happiness, here's to you, the bride and groom, Lauren and Greg.
Hello. I think, first of all, everyone should give a round of applause to the parents of both these kids, because this is truly an awesome night. Good weekend. So the both sets of parents. And then a big thanks to you guys for making us all a part of this. This is awesome. For those who don't know me, my name's Pete. I've been friends with Greg since, I don't know, middle school, about. There was a point in time where he was a permanent fixture on my parents' couch every day after school taking a nap. He went on numerous trips with my family up to Canada for vacation, and we went to the lake house with him and his grandparents every summer. So, and we played hockey with 14 years old. We still do today. He has always been a really loyal, helpful friend, whether it's changing the oil in my car like he does with everybody else here, helped me build a deck at my new house, or the time he gave me his PlayStation when I was grounded for driving around with his beer in my car. Lauren, I've only known for about seven or eight years. You've always been a lot of fun. And like Greg, you're hardworking and smart. It's very obvious to everyone here that these two adore each other. So, you know, you guys make an awesome couple. God willing, someday great parents. And you guys definitely deserve each other, for sure. I know you guys are going to Dominican Republic on Wednesday. Uh-huh. Are your passports in order? Because we went to Mexico at 18, and he brought an expired passport. And I remember him getting fleeced at Mexican customs for all the money in his wallet because they scared the crap out of him. So, and that's about the only story I can tell from Mexico. So. So being that I've been married for 5 years as of last Thursday, I figured I could give you guys a little bit of advice. To both of you, if you guys ever find yourself in a heated argument, don't be afraid to go to bed angry at each other. Because you're going to want that rest so when you get up in the morning you can try to win that fight again. To Lauren, treat Mary and Greg like tiling a floor. Lay them right the first time, you can walk all over them for years. And Greg, marriage is a lot like playing on a hockey team. During the week, you got to do what you're told, work hard, so you have a chance to score on the weekend. My wife always says, happy wife, happy life. Couldn't be more true. Congratulations, you guys, to the bride and groom.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this time, we're going to start with the bride and groom's first dance as husband and wife.
Every time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear your thoughts, I can see your dreams. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love. Just keeps getting better. I wanna spend the rest of my life with you by my side, forever and ever. Every little thing that you do, baby, I'm amazed by you. Keeps getting better.
Let's give them a big round of applause. Now we're looking for the father of the bride for our daddy-daughter dance. All right, let's give them a big round of applause. All right, at this time, it's going to be our mother-son dance.
And always give more than you take, but more than anything.
All right, let's give them a big round of applause. Okay. At this time, I need all the wedding party on the dance floor. You guys are getting this party started. All right, you guys ready? All right, here we go. This time, if anybody else wants to join them, come on up. Let's get this party going.